This is Gridiron Lights with Brad Beck, only on KTVO, because accuracy matters.
Good evening, Heartland. In week four action, Ottumwa hosted Des Moines North. Both teams were looking for their first win. Now, North struck early. It's number five, Bala, rushing. He rushes from 5 yards out. The Polar Bears take a 6-0 lead. On the ensuing kickoff, the Bulldogs get a great return after some blocks. Look at the runner run down the field. He will get the ball at midfield. Then on the first offensive play of the night for the Bulldogs, check this play out. Alex Goodwin with a little play action fake. He'll find a wide open Ben Kramer for the 50-yard touchdown. It's 7-6 Ottumwa. How about some defense? Dedrick Grimes with a great tackle here as the runner will gain no yards for North. And finally, check out the senior Brandon McCall. He's going to block the Polar Bear punt, but North would pick up the ball and get a first down as the runner is still in bounds. But from Schaefer Stadium, the final score is 55-20. Ottumwa gets their first win of the season.
Crooksville was home to face Boonville. Chris Curtis made the short trip across town. Chris, are the Tigers smiling tonight?
Fred, the Pirates rode the sails of that Canadian cold front into Kirksville with 2 straight wins in conference play. Meanwhile, the Tigers opener in conference play, and the faces were all smiles for about 10 seconds. Tigers go 3-and-out on the first possession. Pirates ball. Wes Davis hands off to Dylan Crowley, and he's off to the races. Gets inside of the 30 until Jacob Hutton comes in the picture and takes him down right here. Then Wes Davis again. Oh, it's a Pirates life for him on the ground tonight. Touchdown, Pirates. They would go up 6-0. They do miss the extra point. Next Pirate possession, Davis finds Gus Kemp, who gets the pants a little dirty. 12-0, 2-point conversion is good. 14-0 Pirates. Head coach Chris Daniels, not a happy camper. So Blake Rowley tries to crack some sideline smiles. He returns a punt into Pirate territory and goes for the Superman dive, but the drive would stall. 3-and-out once again for the Tigers. Here's Dylan Crowley, untouched, wide open end zone, and the beat goes on for the Pirates, 21-0. Coach Melvin Barnett can only shake his head in disbelief. Then Wes Davis again finds a treasure chest in the corner. 28-0 Pirates. This one goes final. Kirksville falls 48-7. Next up for the Tigers, a trip to Troy.
In Albia, the Blue Demons welcome Davis County and new quarterback Calvin Utt. Let's take you to the highlights. In the first quarter, Utt goes down the middle and finds Calvin Matthews, who goes in for the score. It's 13-0 Mustangs, and the fans who traveled from Bloomfield are happy. Albia tries to march down the field. Cole Spurgeon gets the ball, and he's going to rumble all the way for 10 yards. But on 4th-and-goal from the 9, Albia goes for it. Brett Leshen completes the pass to Cody McCarty, but he gets stuffed a couple of yards short of the goal line. The Mustang defense holds. However, Albia makes the huge comeback in the second half, and they win 21-20.
Knox County was home, looking to finish up non-conference play on a high note with a win over Fayette. Knox County in black. Leighton McCabe goes left on the speed option and picks up the easy first down. Same drive. This time, the talented senior goes right, and he runs right into your living room for the touchdown. You know what? It's not a one-man show for the Eagles. It's Donovan Edwards. He can also fly. He'll move the chains. Great blocking by Knox County, and Edwards takes it outside for 6. Knox County wins it big, 48-13.
The Fairfield Trojans hosted conference foe Fort Madison. Coming out to battle, quarterback Dylan Fry looks to pass. No one's open, so he runs it for a long 25 yards. And on the next play, no one's open again, so Fry's going to improvise, and he guns it down the sideline for another 20 yards. And then Zach Vivier brought it in for a touchdown. Fairfield is up 6-0 in the first 10 minutes. The Bloodhounds match it. Then Fairfield gets right back in the game with an 8-yard pass to running back Davis Loewenberg. The big man fights for every yard. Next play, the little man. Vivier ducks through the bunch, jukes and jives them, running through the opposite sideline 47 yards and scores a touchdown for the Trojans, bringing the score to 14-6 in the first 9 minutes of the game. The crowd gets animated, but when the Trojans get the ball again, Brent Butch, just waiting by himself for the punt return, he gets the ball and runs it 40 yards down the Trojan sideline. The Trojans later turned that into a touchdown, bringing the score to 21-6 in the first quarter. They go on to trounce the Bloodhounds big and win the game 49-12.
Milan remained undefeated as they beat North Shelby at the Pit. Milan in green, the defense came to play. It's Aaron Richardson with two nice plays for the Wildcats. Meanwhile, Milan scored on the first play from scrimmage. Cooper Bankus takes it 40 yards for the touchdown as the big fella was rumbling. Check out the great blocking by Milan on the line and downfield. It allows Mason Thompson to get outside and get six more points. Then it's going to be Brad Heisler who follows his blockers. Milan wins it 74-0.
Over in Eldon, Cardinal welcomed in North Cedar. Second half highlights, quarterback Dakota Showman takes it himself on the quarterback sweep. That's 10 yards, and it'll be a first down for the Cardinals. This time, Showman will run the option, and he's going to pitch it right here to Tanner Chance. He gets it, and he's going to go 10 yards and another first down to keep the drive alive for the Cardinals. Same drive, drift inside as the halfback toss to Drew Ostrander, who picks it up, and he's going to take it about 15 yards and helps move the chains once again. Then on the fourth down drive, about to stall, Showman finds Donnie Tendity for the first down catch. Look at that great pass right there. He's going to go. And then finally, the icing on the cake for a great drive. Another option, Ostrander finds his way into the end zone for 6 points. However, from there, it was all North Cedar. The final score was 50-6. Now let's check out some other scores from around the heartland.